Previously on the show.
I'm gonna be trying something new and fresh and... Who are you and what are you doing in my house? What? Oh, right. Yeah, I'm you from the future.
Now, back to the show.
Right, this is gonna sound crazy, but you have to walk through this time portal right...
Wait. If you're me from the future, why do you look exactly like me? Well, it's more like 35 seconds or so in the future.
But that doesn't matter. What matters is that you walk through this time portal right here.
Wait, and how long has that been there?
Like 3 months or so. You're not very observant.
Anyways.
What's important is that you walk through this time portal right over here and tell yourself the exact same thing I just told you.
Meeting my future self today got me thinking about something. The future. The future is scary. Now, we all know the future is a scary place, but just how scary is it exactly? See, the future is a place you haven't been yet. It's a place you're going, but you have no idea where you're going and what you're going to. And in that way, it's frightening, because you can't predict it. It's unpredictable. Thousands of people for thousands of years have been trying to predict it and just have failed. An example of the world's unpredictability is that earlier this week, my dad was diagnosed with colon cancer. That's actually when I first started to think about all this future and where we're all going and stuff. You see, whether the future is a positive or negative thing depends on your perception of what's going on to you in the present. For instance, if something good happens to you, you become optimistic. And if something negative happens to you, like a truck driving right through your video, you start to get negative. See, when I found out my dad had colon cancer, all I could do was think about the future in a negative way. The whole time I was down and pessimistic about the entire situation. I started to get really freaked out. I started to wonder what life would be like without my dad there. But then 3 days later, we found out that they could cure the cancer, and they brought him into the hospital for several tests and then cured it within a week. So I began to get slightly more optimistic about the future. You see, the funny thing about the future is that what makes it scary is also what kind of makes it comforting. Realizing that you have no control over the random circumstances that happen in your life is a way of coping. There's this old saying, if life gives you lemons, then make lemonade. You could stress about where those lemons came from, or what you're gonna do when you have them, and how you could mess up. You see, it's that sort of pessimism that leads you to never being satisfied with what you have. On the other hand, you can get all excited about these lemons, and make all these plans about what you're gonna do with these lemons, and when they don't work out, get all your hope crushed. Or option C, you take all those lemons and you make lemonade. The best way you can. Quick video update. Since we're on the subject of the future, I have to bring up the fact that this is a school camera, and with schools closing down for the summer, I might take a week or two to find some other sort of video-making thing in which I can exercise this habit I'm trying to develop of making videos for you to watch. So there may or may not be a drop in quality in the next few weeks, so look forward to that.
You broke what? The universe.
How?
I don't know. The you trapped in the paradox changed something.